Once upon a time, I knew a man called the Doctor. We went to imaginary places and fought creatures of evil. And then one day, it all stopped when the Daleks' master plan went bang. And I aged to death on the ground of Campbell as the Doctor and his young friend, Stephen Taylor, could only but watch. But one day, we went to this house, and it was a strange house. It was the House of Ely, and I left a mind copy of myself there. And so, I lived on. But one day, he came back. That old, daft blue box appeared outside the House of Ely once more. Almost horrified that these ghosts of the past had appeared before my very eyes. I had to hold onto the banister that leads you up the stairs and into the House of Ely from pure shock. And then the doors to the TARDIS opened and the Doctor stepped out. He hadn't changed. He still looked the same as before I died on Campbell. He was followed by a young woman.
Well, Doctor, where are we?
And Stephen himself. He looked directly at me. A tear fell from my eye. The Doctor and the other woman were unaware of what Stephen could see.
Well,
we've been here before, my dear.
Before?
Well, not with you precisely, but me and Stephen have been here before.
Right, I see. Where was it, you said?
House of Ely. Doctor, look. What is it, my dear boy, The Doctor looked in Stephen's direction. Oh, I say. The Doctor had now noticed me.
Doctor, who is it?
This, my dear Dodo. This is our old and deceased friend, Sara Kingdom. The four of us were sat around a table. The atmosphere was awkward. Everyone was silent. The Doctor was staring to space. Dodo, fiddling with a bracelet on her arm. Stephen, looking down in pure dismay. I didn't know what to do, so naturally, I just thought I'd ask a question. To get the conversation rolling and to kill the awkward atmosphere.
So, you're not going to ask how I'm here?
Well, where would I even begin on that, Sarah? The last time we were here, at Ely, I sort of made a mind copy of myself. And so I live on, but here.
So, you're like a ghost, yeah?
Dodo asked.
In a sense, yes. I'm not in a 100% human form, but... yes, I'm a ghost.
I frowned and looked down.
I'm a ghost.
The doctor was still too stunned to speak.
Doctor, don't you have anything to say?
Like what, hmm? What do I have to say? This isn't Sarah, it's not. This is a mind copy.
Doctor, have a bit of sensitivity, please.
He's right, Doctor.
While the Sarah that you knew died on Kembo,
this is still Sara Kingdom. This is still her mind. This place, it's...
Dodo smiled and looked at me.
It's her kingdom.
I smiled back. I liked Dodo. She was different. She had a good effective tone on a doctor and Stephen. And a forever bickering.
What now? Well, I am able to leave, if that's what you're asking.
You mean you want to travel with the three of us?
I put my hands in my head and sighed. I don't know what I want to do. If I'd want to stay here at Ely, or go and live a new life somewhere, or go with you.
I thought of all the amazing things I'd seen with the doctor and Stephen, the Sontarans.
Everything I had seen, the amount of times we celebrated Christmas, everything. I didn't want to let go. This is what would happen. I knew that if the doctor and Stephen were to come back for me, this is exactly what would happen. I would get carried away and my emotions would come out. Why did I let myself? Why? Just why?
Dodo noticed me staring into space.
You're more than welcome to come and join us. Me, the Doctor, and Stephen. We'd love to have you, wouldn't we?
The Doctor bit his finger. Stephen stared down. It was clear that Stephen was still traumatized about the events on Campbell and my death.
You see, Sarah, after we lost you, we met a young man named Oliver Harper.
I see.
And he perished not long after we met him. An incident with Vardens.
Vardens? What she said, what are Vardens?
I'll explain later. I don't know if I can put myself through losing you again, Sarah. What happened on Kembo and then what happened to Oliver?
Stephen looked at the doctor.
And then Anne. I don't know if I can do that again. I don't know if I can. It was too much last time. And what if it's too much this time?
Stephen looked at me. He was holding back tears.
And I'll confess, so was I.
I thought hard. I thought so hard that I gave myself a headache and
I didn't think that was possible anymore.
I sighed again. I couldn't do this to Stephen. If what happened last time hurt him so bad, could I really put myself and him through that once more, knowing what kind of effect it had on him? I began to cry. Stephen. Doctor. Dodo. I don't think I can come with you. It hurt to say that. Have you ever wanted something so bad? But know that if you have it, it will hurt and ruin things. I want to come with you, I do, but I can't put you through it again. Not after what happened last time. Doctor. You showed me incredible places. And for that, I thank you so much. But it stopped being fun when I died. I think we should go. Please. I looked at Dodo and nodded. Come on, Doctor. Come on, Stephen.
Dodo left the room, and Stephen and the doctor followed her. I followed behind them. As they walked down the stairs and approached the TARDIS, I stood on the steps and waved. The sun had come out and went across my face. I smiled.
Goodbye, Doctor. Goodbye, Stephen. Goodbye, Dodo. Good luck.
I held back the tears. Dodo smiled sympathetically before entering the TARDIS. And for the last time, it dematerialized. And for the last time, I watched the TARDIS fade away before my very eyes. I cried. And I cried, and I cried, and I cried. All alone once more, Sarah. I thought, and looked into the distance. You go out there, and you be strong, and you do things your own way. I walked down the steps, took in a breath of fresh air, and walked off into the distance. Have been listening to Doctor Who Short Trips Destinies Kingdom, written by R.B. Wilson and read by Ray Dunlap. Doctor Who Short Trips Destinies Kingdom is a Fallout Productions production.